That grew out of teaching 10 lectures in biology too. And when I gave lectures, I essentially outlined them and had some, instead of a word like pH, I would have a sentence. And then I had long come to the conclusion that you cannot think and write at the same time. And so you can't understand a lecture if you're taking down notes. And so students shouldn't take notes. And so I passed out lecture notes. The students still took notes, even though I passed out the lecture notes. But the lecture notes would be, you know, what you should know to pass the exam. There was, at that stage, no textbook on DNA. And so the molecular biology, or some of the middle chapters, came out of the lecture notes. And then I thought, you should write a couple of chapters of introduction so a physicist or chemist might be able to read the book. So you should give a 15-page summary of the great moments in Mendelian genetics, or give, 15 to 20 pages which summarize the basic facts of metabolism, of how cells get and use energy. And then I realized you probably should have a chapter on how molecules fold up in three dimensions. So I ended up, I think, with five introductory chapters, which were not in my lecture notes, but were trying to broaden the readership. So if you were a physicist and wanted to read it, you get the basic principles, and you didn't need to know any more details. So that proved to be, and then that was it. So I started, the book started out with DNA. My courses started out with, but then I realized, no, that's not the way to start the book. The book should start with Darwin and put DNA in perspective to what Darwin and Mendelian, where we were, say, in 1945. And it was in, I was writing the molecular biology of gene and the double helix at the same time. So I remember writing the first pages of the molecular biology of the gene in October. It was an awful October. All right, it was October 1963, when Kennedy was killed. So that's when I started. And I wrote the first chapter at the end of August. I was going out to Australia, and they wanted some material. And I thought, oh, I could be a way to go into a book. And so I tried to write a one-page, the first paragraph on Darwin, and then go on. And I wanted to write literature. So I wanted it to not sound like the average biology text, but write it as if it's the Bible or something like that.